Jesus will tell them, I don't know you. They said, but sir, I was born inside church. And I done that, I done that. I healed the sick. Now, how come someone who healed the sick, Jesus said, I don't know you?
Where did you have to come?
Now, if they have charm in their pocket, do you think they have the courage to meet Jesus? It's what their parents told them, that this is the family church, this is the church. So that's what they carry, and they were thinking. That's why in Acts of Apostles chapter 10, the Bible said there was a man called Cornelius, a centurion of the Italian man. He prayed to God always, he do fasting, he give hand, but the man is not born again. Jesus is coming back very soon. But I don't know the date he's coming. The Bible said he'll come like a thief. For us to have peace in this community, we need Jesus. For us to have life, for us to have peace in this community, we need God, not church. How many of you know that you are all kings and princes?
Yes.
Now, let me tell you one secret. Before now, God does not speak to everybody. He speaks to only a prophet and a priest. When Eli was made king, if you like, you are a big man, you go, God will not speak to you. In 2 Kings chapter 20, King Hezekiah was sick unto death. He was praying, God not speak to him. God speak to Isaiah. Go and tell him that he will die. When Isaiah told him, he turned to the wall and began to pray. God sent him, said, go back and tell him I've had 15 years. Why didn't God talk to him? Because that time God talked to a priest and the prophet. But this era we are, in Revelation chapter 5, verse 10, the Bible says Jesus died and made all of us king and priests unto God. But the problem we have is that many of us don't know our position as a king. In 1 Peter 2, 9, it says you are royal priests with choosing generation, peculiar people. That's why you can't see me in beer parlor. Have you seen a sheep stand for beer parlor with people drink? We go there drink for us, not so. Can you see a monk of Calabar in the beer parlor? He's a king. But some of us don't know that we are king. We can't even fight in marketplace. Don't have respect for senior people. Praise the Lord. Jesus is coming. I don't know when he's coming. I said one, how do we know those in Christ? Your name will change. Somebody will not call you sheep. They say, man of God, a tape pastor. Only, only. Some of them are not happy that you are the chairman. They'll carry your name to maybe a Kwame and this. When they reach there, they slot the name. The Juju will say, Pom, Pom, as they come back, they will come and they say, hey, say pastor, hey, say pastor. Because you carry light. That's why Matthew 5:14 says, children of God are the light of the world. They are like a city built on top of a hill. They don't hide. No man light a candle and put it on a bushel. You put it on the candlestick. Let your light shine before men. Let men see and glorify God. So if people are not seeing you, now if this woman is a child of God and I say I like her, people say, God, don't go down and what I mean. No wonder 1 John 4:4 say, greater is he that is in you than he that is in you. So Christianity is not about going to church. Christianity is to manifest, for people to see. And another thing, once you have Christ, you have peace of mind. You may not have food, you may not have anything, but you have peace of mind. It's only God that can give you peace. Isaiah chapter 9, verse 6. Jesus is the Prince of Peace. Today we bring the peace of God.
Amen. Amen. Amen.
Now, the meaning of Jesus is coming is this. One, our own death is coming. Nobody knows when, where, how he or she will die. If you die today, Jesus will come for you. Number two, some of us said from their great grandfather time, they say, Jesus is coming, Jesus is coming. Who all am here? Man of God, don't deceive me. This man will not come in my time. Let me join myself. But the Bible says in 2 Peter chapter 3, verse 8, it says, 1,000 years is a day for God. And one day for God is 1,000. That means Jesus died 2 days ago. We have entered the second day. We have entered the third day. Spiritually, third days are significant. That's why pastor said, go for 3 days fast. Go for 3 days to deliver. Jesus himself died and resurrected on the third day. When Abraham was asked to sacrifice Isaac, Abraham located Mount Moriah on the third day. When the Jews were to be eliminated, Esther put on a royal apparel, entered the king's palace on the third day. When David was hiding in Ziklag, Amalek had attacked Ziklag on the day. And the Bible says, three bear witness in heaven, God the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. What shall it profit a man if you remain in church and lose your soul? If you are here and you have not moved to Christ, you are still playing church, today is another opportunity. You can lift up your hand, I will pray with you. What I can assure you is that tonight you have divine encounter.
Amen.
The Holy Spirit will visit and be directed.
Amen.
That is where you will see your children doing well. You will have grief. People say, I say, what is the problem? How do you feel? You will see. Amen. Now, as a DP, I said, no, I will not take money from Bill. People say, how do you survive? Then I survive. Because if the bed in the earth can survive, we can also survive. So if you are here, I want to dominate. I want to overcome. I want to be in Christ, lift up your hand. I'm ending now. I want to pray with those people. So that in the night, let heaven open. Let heaven open. Let heaven reveal himself. So that you can dominate. You will say after me, oh God, my Father. I am a sinner.
I am a sinner.
I have sinned against thee. Have mercy upon me. Let your precious blood.
Cover
all my needs.
Today,
I declare Jesus Christ as my Lord,
as my
personal Savior.
I
believe in
my heart.
I confess with my mouth.
God
raised Jesus from death.
Remove
my name
from
the book of death.
And
write my name
in
the book of life.
Thank
you for saving me.
In
Jesus' name.
Amen.
Amen. Heavenly Father, I commit your children into your heart. None can come to Jesus, come to God, except you call them. Father, these ones you have called, I pray. From today, every voice, altar, power, covenant, blood speaking against them shall speak no more.
Amen.
In the mighty name of Jesus.
Amen.
From today, anytime you call upon you, answer them.
Hallelujah.
Anyone, Father, no one can enter the rain without getting wet. Because they have decided to surrender to you, I pray.
Oh, yes.
Tonight, let there be divine
revelation.
Grant them divine revelation.
Amen.
In the mighty name of Jesus.
Amen.
King of kings and the Lord of lords. Every closed door, Father, shall be opened.
Amen.
Beginning from today, because they have surrendered, good things begin to happen in this
place. Amen. Amen.
No, as mountains surround Jerusalem, let the mountains surround
Jerusalem. Amen.
Every evil one, let the Spirit of God begin to haunt them.
Amen.
Let this evil one begin to lose their sleep.
Amen.
In the mighty name of
Amen.
Jesus. Father, the grace will save you, the grace will love you, the grace will draw near to you.
Give unto
you. In the mighty name of Jesus.
Amen.
The blood that speaks good to you.
Amen.
In Jesus' mighty name.
Amen. Amen.